Welcome back to the Tagata Pasifika Anzac Special. 3 years after World War II ended, New Zealand went to war again, this time in Malaya, then Korea, Borneo and Vietnam. Pacific soldiers again put up their hands to fight, but it would take decades for Vietnam vets to finally have their moment in the sun. Here's John Altunga.
Welcome home parades are nothing new in this country, but this one in 2008 was the one these Vietnam veterans had waited over 30 years to have.
Oh, too emotional. Too emotional.
When the Vietnam War ended in the early 70s and soldiers returned home, they were spat and jeered at and smuggled in the back door. There was no hero's welcome, just a lot of anti-war protests from their fellow Kiwis who opposed the war. And finally, 3 decades later, the veterans were given their official apology from the New Zealand government.
The Crown extends to New Zealand Vietnam veterans and their families an apology.
And an official welcome home parade.
You know, you don't shake hands, you hug. You know, some of them I haven't seen for years.
Most of the people come here to meet the comrades and, you know, and have a few drinks together and stop a few lines and cry together.
More than 3,000 New Zealanders served in Vietnam between 1963 and 1975. It was the first war in which New Zealand did not fight alongside its traditional ally, Great Britain. Instead, it was a measure of the increasing importance of the ANZUS alliance with the US and Australia. For our Pacific soldiers who fought in Vietnam, it was a harrowing experience, as we found in this Tangata Pasifika story from 2005.
In Vietnam, you never knew what was going to happen. You know, I know the first thing I said was, I said to myself, I said, what the hell I'm doing here?
One night, we were going to be cleaned out by the Viet Cong. That was a bad feeling, and I learned from that night that I can survive.
I went to Vietnam with a full platoon, and I came back with a full platoon.
And I thought that rocket hit that guy, you know, direct. I thought he's dead. But when the flare went up, and I saw him lying there, blood covered his face. And then I thought, we're going to be cleaned out. We'll be all dead, because we're going to run short of ammunition. And then the fire support arrived.
Another to serve was Samoan Theo Brunt. These images were filmed by him when he served as an air dispatcher with an Australian helicopter crew.
Mixed feelings, you know. I was there, I was glad to be there to do what I was taught to do. And on the other side, I said, I wonder if I'm going home again.
We landed in Singapore. The guys actually, everyone took their strap off and they were jumping up and down on the plane when the plane landed. They didn't care what, you know, if they break their leg or whatever. They were just happy to be back away from there.